I'm part of a department called the Department of Animal Environment and Health, and we do research on animal husbandry systems, feeding systems, management, housing in general, welfare issues a lot. So for farm animals, but also other species. My main areas have traditionally been poultry welfare. So I've been working with that. It's like stocking density for broilers, housing system for laying hens, etc. But now also working with other species, such as cattle, for example. But also reasons for health and disease, looking at epidemiology of various management related diseases. And in later years, also focusing quite a lot on slaughterhouses, how to handle animals prior to slaughter and how to stun them in the best possible way to avoid any unnecessary pain and suffering. I'm definitely very, very proud, and it's not just for me, but it's for my research team, my co-workers, and the entire university, but also all the international contacts that I have helped me to become even more interested in the topic of animal welfare. So my colleagues at the Federation of Veterinarians in Europe, the EFSA panel, Animal Health and Animal Welfare panel, where I used to be a member, etc. All very inspiring colleagues that have helped me to get where I am today. Antibiotic resistance is definitely an issue globally, but here in Sweden we've had a very restrictive policy on antibiotics for veterinary use, but also for human use, which means that it's only used for sick animals and people who really need it. And we also import meat, of course. So we're certainly still very interested in the discussion on antibiotic resistance and continue to work on that. And I'm involved in one of these projects trying to see how antibiotic resistance bacteria spread from very densely inhabited areas to more pristine areas all over the world. So animal welfare as a scientific subject has developed dramatically over the last decades, being seen not as us just being kind to the animals, but as a scientific topic in its own right. But it's also developing among the public, the awareness of the link between animal welfare, animal health, antibiotic resistance, and other aspects are all important to us as consumers. And it's a sustainability issue, really, and that's now being recognized not only in highly developed countries, but really globally in all parts of the world. This is something that we have to look at if we're going to continue to keep animals the way we are.